enthusiasts and relaxation seekers. My name is Cinephile Samar, and today we are talking about Lin-Manuel Miranda's directorial debut, Tick Tick Boom. First and foremost, before I dive into my thoughts and the overall story behind Tick Tick Boom, can I just say how great it is to see Andrew Garfield in a movie? The man hasn't taken a hiatus or took a break from acting. It's just always a treat to see him in a film. He's just so lovable, and his aura just emulates in every performance. I love Garfield. Not the cat, the actor. Alright, so I got that out of the way. With Tick Tick Boom, the only real knowledge that I had going into this was that it was Lin-Manuel Miranda's directorial debut. His contributions to Broadway and the musical scene is far more than my limited education within that field could service, but his implications are going to be felt for a lifetime. So this being his first directed film, I was intrigued. Not knowing much about the plot, going in, I'm going to give a brief synopsis of the film. Following Jonathan Larson, an aspiring playwright who has worked on a certain play for years, he has put blood, sweat, and tears into everything. It is such a unique concept, but nobody will touch it. No studio, no company will get near this thing. So when he gets all of his money, puts everything on the line to create a workshop in hopes to get this thing bought, he is pushed to his limits as a creative. And as he's just about to turn 30, everything starts to come into question, whether he's doing the right thing or whether or not he's been wasting his time for decades doing a profession that won't grant him what he wants. Right out the gate, when you watch this movie, you're going to be struck by some of the most unique structuring and pacing of a movie, and especially a musical, I think you'll ever encounter. This film puts you behind the wheel and the head of Jonathan Larson, a man who, like many of us, myself included, is a creative whose mind is never stopping. Even when there's those mental inevitable roadblocks, Larson, like most of us, just keep persistently going. And the editing and flow of this movie is so dizzying and disorienting that it could put you off, as it did for me within the first 15 minutes. But once you get into the movie and you understand its rhythm and its beat and its flow, that's when you are unlocked into a world and you do not want to get out of it. I gotta let you guys know though, you do not need to be a fan of musicals, of Broadway, to enjoy this movie. I love me my musicals, but I'm not a big fan of Broadway. I respect the art, but that isn't for me. This movie breaks that boundary. Yes, it is about an aspiring playwright, but at its core, it's a finding one's own journey. It's going into circumstances that questions your morals and whether or not what you want to do is what you want to do based off of the world trying to tell you no. It is looking at the face of doubt and saying screw you, pushing through that. And there's so much more, like an identity crisis narrative, and every bit of it. I'm young, but I was able to stick with it so heavily. But I also think it comes hand in hand with the fact that this is a true inspired story. I didn't know Jonathan Larson was a real individual up until this movie, after what he was trying to get off the ground, which you'll see in this movie. And then he did Tick Tick Boom, and then he did Rent, and the tragedy behind his eventual passing at the age of 35, the literal night before Rent premiered in its previews, and that became one of the most renowned and embedded into the fabric of Broadway's iconic history. It's one of the highest grossing plays, and it just goes to show how brilliant Jonathan Larson was and is to this day, but he wasn't given the attention necessary. Like I said though, this movie moves at a breakneck pace, visualized by such chaotic imagery and a flow that I doubt you will ever say you have witnessed before. It isn't a typical structure which starts from point A with Larson getting the idea to make this play. No, it starts at him with this play dealing with it, but also him in Tick Tick Boom, as it is basically a biography of his life told by him. And it's so fitting that this movie takes place with that in mind, because this is an individual whose implication breaks Broadway. This is a man trying to tell stories that far break the mold of a musical. This is a human story, whether it be Tick Tick Boom, Rent, you name it. And Lin-Manuel Miranda so faithfully adapts this, and he said in interviews, if he was given the ability to make one movie, it was this. And it shows, with a man with such talent as him, I could totally understand why Jonathan Larson would be such a staple for him in terms of inspiration. I was absolutely floored from point A to point B to point Z with this movie. Every step of the way, I became more and more invested. You get to learn these characters, but Jonathan Larson, Andrew freaking Garfield, this man has some vocal range. Holy moly macaroni, this movie is hard hitting with its music, with its themes, with its message. I mean, I love musicals, but I have not felt this personally connected to a musical since Across the Universe or La La Land, and my hat goes off to everyone involved. This has got to be one of the most personal stories expressed onto the big screen, as it's part fiction, part non-fiction, part almost like documentary in a sense, but everybody in this film gives it their A game. Andrew Garfield, as usual, gives a beautifully transcendent performance, where if you look at what Jonathan Larson has done as a character on and off the stage, it is recreated almost to a perfect T, and that needs to be talked about. Or to compliment Garfield's performance, you have Robin DeJesus playing Michael, which is Larson's best friend, and oh my gosh, the waterworks will be coming in this movie for so many reasons. Like I said, this tackles identity, questioning what you want to do, but also deals with the AIDS epidemic in a lot of really heartbreaking ways, but it's all to uplift a story that is so fundamentally necessary that I couldn't imagine a musical breaking that. And I know Steven Spielberg's West Side Story is coming out with that creep Ansel Elgort, but I'm making the statement right now, this is the best musical of the entire year. It's one of the best musicals of the decade. This level of personal connection to a story. You literally had Larson's sister on set helping, trying to give Garfield notes as to what her brother would best act like in certain situations. And I gotta give it to Lin-Manuel Miranda. This is the true star of the movie. He gives it everything. There is a lot of very technical achievements in this movie, visually and directing-wise, that I'm just like flabbergasted why he hasn't done this sooner. Honestly, I really wasn't expecting to fall head over heels for this movie, but look where I am now. 2021 has shown, with movies such as this, that you can have an incredible year of varying different genres, themes, and movies at large. And with that being said, Andrew Garfield, Robin DeJesus, Lin-Manuel Miranda, an excellent story, a beautiful one that transcends the typical and conventional editing pacing norm, with a very dizzying, disorienting, but reassuring watch by you being in Larson's head, one of the most profound and incredible individuals, not only in Broadway, but in the art medium at large. This movie is beautiful. It'll hit you like a sack of bricks, and if you aren't left inspired to do what you want to do, or at least get up and find purpose to figure out what it is you do want to do, I don't know, man. You guys, you're crazy, because this movie's friggin' great. I love it. I can't wait to rewatch it. This is going to be a staple, and I'm going to give it, with all that being said, an A. A serious, strong A. Honestly, I'm just as surprised as you guys are. I love this movie. I would say maybe the only reason why I haven't given it an A+, with all of my rave accolades, and not really a distinguishable flaw, is because 2021 has been a stacked year. I'm starting to compile a list of my favorites, and there's probably 10, 12 films that I would give a perfect 5 out of 5 to, and I don't try to go about that very easily. But this movie is worth every praise. I loved it. I can't wait to watch it again. Let me know what you thought of Tick, Tick, Boom. What has been your favorite musical, or the one that's hit you the hardest? Drop them down in the comments, as I'd love to hear every one of your guys' thoughts and opinions. Thank you so much for